I was a young man when last I walked this path. There's an old trading post not far from here. The road to Drake's Fang leads through it.
The trading post it is.
Our destination lies over that dune, beyond the ruins. Mark 'em well, Clive. It's all too easy to lose one's bearings in the sands.
Run like the wind.
You deserve a rest.
I'm not surprised you don't remember. It was just before Joshua was born. You were so eager to be there when your brother arrived, but you whipped your chocobo too hard on the journey home and fell from the saddle. I shall never forget how Elwyn fussed over you as you sat in the sand, bawling like a baby.
come on.
Who do you think those soldiers were in the inn?
Friends of friends, I'd wager. I think that they looked very friendly.
So, Lord Cook has finally made his move?
Yes. I expect that's why there's so many soldiers in town, to deal with any Imperial reprisals.
Ready, go?
You deserve a rest.
Let's go.
Have you lost your way already, my boy? The ruins mark the road to the inn.
Time to fight.
Farewell. Get up. All your sorrows.
Thank you.
Me, boy. Nice try.
It should have stayed in its shell.
There she is, the good old Dalamil Inn. Do you know, this heat has given me quite a thirst. Quick drink before we press on?
Look, there. Those are Ashen steeds. No doubt about it.
And such a long ride from Stonehere. Our Waluda friends must be soothing their saddle sores in the inn. Shall we join them? Run along and play now, Torgal. Dogs aren't allowed inside.
Good day to you. Eating?
Sorry about my pal. He only talks when his mouth's full. What do you recommend?
Well, if you're after something light, we do a fine chocobo soup with lentils and honey.
Two bowls of that, then. An ale.
Right you are.
Hey, girl!
Coming!
Your pal?
Would you rather be my squire? Thank you.
Your Grace, it is plain you are not yet well enough to travel. If you would only let me take you to someone who can better attend to your ills.
No, we must press on. Prince Theon has returned to his camp and will soon depart for the front. I must speak with him at all costs. Miss this chance and I may never get another. You do understand that?
Yes, Your Grace. But you must at least agree to take your medicine. I'll fetch you some water.
Keep watch, they tell us. But all I see is sand.
I hear they got our guest back to the Fang without any trouble. We'll be leaving soon enough.
Why the Lord Commander dragged us all this way just to save that blockhead skin, we'll never know. Dominant or not, he's a bloody idiot.
That'll be Cooker, then.
Well, let's get this down us. We have a long way to go.
Hey, you!
Uncle?
Sorry.
Can you walk, Your Grace?
What's wrong?
I fear trouble may be brewing downstairs.
You two are travelers, are you not? Me and my companions are strangers here. Perhaps you'd be good enough to accompany us a while. Help us find our way.
Sorry, lads. But we've got business in camp that can't wait.
Ah, I'm sure you could spare us an hour or two.
Come on, go. Come on. Come on.
Friend.
I'm afraid we don't have a moment to lose. Friend! Stay back, Uncle.
Gladly.
Take him!
Try it.
for your trouble. Word of advice, miss. That soup could do with a touch more salt.
Now's our chance. Your Grace?
I'm fine.
Clive? What is it now?
It's nothing. Let's go.
Didn't know where to find Kupka before. We do now.
The royalists said it themselves. Their guest is in the Fang. We should press on before any more of their friends turn up.
After it.
Fresh bread, warm from the oven.
Here, have a taste.
Take a sniff, good sir. You'll be transported.
The finest fabrics, fresh from the capital.
Clumsy lout.
If anything's damaged, it's the lash for you.
Some people can't handle their drink.
Sorry, but the master's not here at the moment. All orders have to go through him.
You could melt butter in that furnace. Get it stoked.
Right away.
Why is the tavern shut?
The inn's a mess of blood-soaked splinters, thanks to you. The least you can do is let us clean up in peace. I told the guard those soldiers started it. Don't need any more trouble.
Mm-hmm.
treat you. I'm pretty flush these days.
Are you now?
I need a drink.
Close the road, and it's the only way from here to the Fang. It would seem Lord Kupka is not accepting visitors at present.
We have to get through that gate.
Not by force, I trust. We've attracted quite enough unwanted attention already.
By guile, then. Perhaps the Desert Hare can offer us her aid.
Rosina Dalamil, woman of mystery. But how will we find her? We know naught of her but her name.
And that she was working with Cid. Cid's other collaborators have all been people of means, the wealthiest and most successful members of their communities. I'll wager this Rosina Dalamil is the same.
That would certainly help to narrow the search. We need only inquire as to who is in charge of the town.
And that's exactly what I mean to do.
Wait, incense! Wash wax candle!
Plates and pots! Bowls and basins!
How about a hot bath to soothe the aches and pains of the road?
This town is truly blessed. The bustling markets, the healing waters, and all under the watchful eye of Lord Kupka, who stands ready to crush any threat that might face us.
Do I have to tell you? It's not a toy.
Good day, my lord. Here you are. An excellent choice. Here you are. Fare you well.
The gate is closed by order of Lord Kupka. Any attempt to gain passage to Drake's Fang will be punished with arrest and incarceration.
Crystal delivery's over. Get back to your homes.
But I didn't get one.
Light it, for Gilbert's sake. You're a bearer, aren't you? I was a fool to waste good coin on you.
It's all the fault of this blasted war. The moment they find out you're from the Empire, they flat out refuse to do business with you.
Won't you come and play, handsome?
Your arms are like iron. Are all your muscles so hard?
Well, I'd be happy to show you, provided I can afford it.
1,000 gil for a measly bunch of gazal greens?
I named my price. If you can't pay it, that's your problem.
Anything I can help you with, travelers?
Allow me. My good man, we represent one of the oldest and greatest trading houses of Port Isolde. We're seeking to expand our business in the region and would very much like to make the acquaintance of Dalimil's leading entrepreneurs. If only we knew where to find them.
Well, we're best known for our baths, our markets, and our smithies. I suppose you could do worse than start your search at one of those.
Thank you. You've been most helpful. You wouldn't happen to know a lady by the name of Rosina Dalimil, would you?
No. I can't say I do.
Well, thank you all the same.
Dalimil is famous for its spas, its markets, and its smithies. Somebody at one of those might be able to help you.
This river runs all the way to the southern seas. They used to load the crystal onto barges and sail it to the villages downstream, before the canyons were lost to beasts and bandits. When I was a girl, I would wave to the boatmen as they set off on their long journey, and they would throw me sweetmeats in return. Such happy times.
What do you want? Can't you see I'm busy?
I won't keep you long. I'm looking for someone. A woman by the name of Rosina Dalimil. Do you know her?
Never heard of her. Is that all?
One more question. If I wanted to find the richest trader in town, where would you recommend that I look?
Well, that's easy. The Briar's Kiss. Won't find a finer smithy this side of the strait. The owner's only a young sprig. But he's got all the right ideas.
The Briar's Kiss, you say? Thank you.
I doubt this young sprig is the person we're looking for. You said Sid's contact was likely to be an influential sort. Influence comes with age and experience, believe you me.
That boy at the Briar's Kiss is a real talent. People flock from miles around to buy his steel. And it isn't cheap, either.
1,000 gil for a meal.
Fight it for Gilbert's sake.
Looks like we won't be getting back to Drake's Fang anytime soon.
Mummy, I want to play with the crystal.
How many times do I have to tell you? It's not.
Can I help you?
Yes, I'm looking for a woman by the name of Rosina Dalimil. A long-standing pillar of your community, I believe, from old trading stock.
Then you should ask Ferda. He's been here for years. Knows the place and its people like the back of his hand. And he's in with all the old merchant families. Try the baths. That's where you'll usually find him.
Thank you kindly.
Ask for Ferda at the baths. If this woman you're looking for is still around, he'll know where to find her.
Well, it sounds like we have our man.
Perhaps. Let's go and find out exactly what this Ferda knows. Excuse me. Are you Ferda?
I am. Can I help you, travelers?
I hope so. You've lived here for some time, is that correct? Do you know Rosina Dalimil? We believe she may be a trader of some renown.
And what business do you have with the Desert Hare?
She was a close friend of mine. I was hoping she might be able to help me.
Very well. Go to the bordello. I'll arrange an introduction. I know who you're looking for. Go to the bordello and wait there.
Do you think we can trust him?
Only as far as I think he trusts us.
So you're the ones who've been sniffing around.
I beg your pardon?
Don't play the fool. Stick your nose in our business and you're likely to lose it.
Who are you working for? Him or her?
Him. The boss. He wanted us to test you.
Though one could hardly call that a test.
Lord Ferder?
Look what the cat dragged in. Your skill with a blade is rare indeed, my lord. A fitting talent for an outlaw.
You know who I am. So what now? Call in the men of the Rock and collect the bounty?
That isn't my decision to make. Our work is done. Take him to meet his precious Rosina. She will be interested to make his acquaintance.
Yes, my lord. To the Lock of Leisure, then.
To the Lock of Leisure.
Passed the test, Sid. Off you go now. Rosina Dalimil awaits.
Made from the stoutest stoneware.
The juiciest meat from Green's bed.
My carpet!
Is this the place?
Lubor's Forge. The Briar's Kiss.
Ah, so it was the young sprig after all.
So much for Rosina Dalimil being a woman of experience. How wrong I was.
It was an easy mistake to make, Uncle. After all, it must have been years since Sid last saw her. Sorry, him. Whoever this Lubor truly is, he's clearly a man of means. I'd say he deserves our respect.
See that he gets it. Lubor,
Lord Ferda told me to bring them to you.
My boys tell me you're in need of assistance.
Sid the Second?
I won't waste your time. I need passage through the South Gate.
Tell me, what do you think is a merchant's most important commodity? Why, trust. Everyone knows that. Without it, you have nothing. And nothing is exactly what you have. And so, for you, I do have nothing. I'm not in the business of helping every lost puppy that wanders in off the street. I'm a busy man, as you can see.
Let's leave this mummer to his farce.
By all means. Find someone else to help you on your way. Just be sure to tell them you're not the two travelers from the inn the guards are looking for. Don't want them jumping to conclusions, do we?
Why, you... So, what do we need to do to earn your trust?
I like this one. Willing to do whatever it takes to get what he wants. Men like you have a special place in my heart. Why, you ask? Because they get me what I want. Always.
Fine. So what do you want?
Don't tell me you're going to listen to this swaggering scruff!
We might as well hear him out. It's only natural that an ally of Cid's would seek assurances of strangers. Assuming he is an ally, of course. 5 years ago, he would have still been a boy.
And yet even then I had more good sense than a man... Oh, 5 times my age? But enough of the pleasantries. We were speaking of what I want. I want you to put an end to the trouble in Dalamil. Return to me when you have done so, and you shall have my aid. Until then, I bid you good day.
What trouble? If you're going to give us orders, be clear about them, damn you!
Manners, Greybeard. One catches more damselflies with honey than with vinegar.
What did you call me?
My apologies. A word of advice in recompense. Follow the crystals. Oh, but that was 3. Oh, I'm making this too easy for you.
Ha! It will be easy. Solving his little riddle should be like dealing with him. Child's play. Let us divide our forces, Clive. I'd rather not drag this parlor game on any longer than we need to.
All right. Good luck, Uncle. I thought we were the only ones causing trouble in Dalamil.
The misfortune Dalamil finds herself in is of a crystalline nature. So do be discreet in your inquiries,
Master Lubor has high expectations of you. Don't disappoint him.
Excuse me. Is it true there's been trouble with crystals of late?
You've heard, then?
I've heard rumors.
Damn thieves. Pilfering the crystals that were meant to fill our cups and light our stoves. Us common folk have hardly had a shard to share between us these last few moons. And it isn't as if we can buy them on the black market either. Whoever's taking them, they aren't sharing. There's cartloads of crystal coming out of Drake's Fang every day. Meanwhile, we're all having to get by with half-spent shards. Someone's siphoning it off.
A deposit?
Information, my good man. Now, listen carefully.
Do you have a moment?
Depends what for.
Just a question. Dalamil seems to be thriving compared to the other villages I came through on the way. Is there a reason for that?
Well, we're a stone's throw from Drake's Fang, for one. The soldiers guarding the Mother Crystal and the shipments need a place to spend their hard-earned gil. The men of the Rock throw their money about like there's no tomorrow.
Is that so? Well, thank you. Don't let me keep you from your work any longer.
The most fragrant herbs
in the world.
Silken softness.
You wouldn't believe how much he gave me. Well, I hope you gave as good as you got. What can I do for you, soldier? Need that sword polishing?
I'm not a soldier.
Oh, then be off with you. I serve the men of the Rock and the men of the Rock only.
You have an agreement with them?
Don't be stupid. I just know which side my bread is buttered. Don't want to be stuck under some pauper when they come knocking. With pockets deeper than Zemeckis and an urge to empty them. No, just leave, will you? Before you scare them off.
I think I'm starting to get an idea of what's been going on. I wonder if Uncle Byron's learned anything of use. He'll probably be back at the inn by now.
The juiciest meat from Breeze. My carpets have pride and place.
What was all that crashing and banging about before?
Some out-of-towners picked a fight with the guard, I heard. Got cracked skulls for their trouble.
It's you, the one who broke all our furniture. What do you want? Haven't you caused enough trouble already?
I'm looking for my pal. Have you seen him?
The gentleman who was with you? Yes, he's upstairs, but...
Thank you. I'll go and fetch him.
The inn's a mess of blood-soaked splinters, thanks to you.
Let me treat you. I'm pretty flush these days.
Are you now?
Will this suffice as a deposit?
By the sands. That's a black pearl.
One of the many treasures in my collection that I would be only too happy to part with, should you give me reason to do so.
All right. I'm sure that we can come to an agreement, but not here.
What are you doing, Uncle? Care to explain why you're giving gifts to Kupka's men?
Bait, my boy. One cannot catch one's prey without it. And I do believe I've snagged us quite the quarry. I started by asking around the markets as to where I might purchase crystals. I had no luck, of course. It's forbidden to trade in such things. But my uncharacteristic indiscretion just happened to attract the attention of those uniformed ruffians. They took me aside and said they could procure the crystal I sought if I proved I could pay for it.
So the pearl was your proof?
I thought they'd ask for more. A second-rate specimen like that would only fetch 500,000 or so. A small price to pay for admittance to the underworld. But enough about my little act of subterfuge. What did you discover?
That the supply of crystals has dried up of late. And some people seem to think they're being stolen. Meanwhile, members of Kupka's private guard have been spending money all over town. I'll wager those soldiers you've been talking to have been siphoning off crystals meant for elsewhere, and pocketing the profits.
I'll wager you're right.
We'll meet with them then, just as you arranged, and put an end to the trouble Lubor spoke of.
Ha! That preening popinjay thought this would be difficult. It just goes to show, one should never underestimate a Rosfield. We'll soon wipe that smirk off his face. I arranged to meet with the soldiers in a secluded corner of the Velcroy, far from prying eyes.
The perfect place for a spot of double dealing.
I trust I can count on your support, if things turn sour.
Of course.
Let me treat you.
I need a drink.
Fucking men of the wrong.
Hanging lanterns, keep the darkness from your...
Just look at the deep...
Lights and buds! Holes
and... Do you think they'll be back soon? I need a new dress.
Fresh bread, warm from the oven.
Yes, they're quite sore.
The rest.
Kill!
Let's go.
Fly, Ambrosia.
I'll take it from here.
I was beginning to think you weren't coming, my lord. You've brought your contribution?
All the silver and stones I could scrape together at such short notice?
You brought the whole 500 talents.
That was the price we agreed upon, yes? If you've no objections, I'd like to see the crystal.
Of course. Right this way, my lord.
Not bad at all. You weren't lying about the clarity. But what of security? If I were to be stopped on the road, what guarantee have I that it wouldn't be seized as property of the Republic?
Because these crystals are no longer the property of the Republic. You're not buying from us. You're buying from them.
And we have no more jurisdiction here than you, my lord. But we have ships, and will gladly deliver to a port of your choosing, now that our price has been met.
Royalists, eh? What brings you here?
Why, to collect their share of Drake's Fang's blessing, of course. Our nations are allies, and so they are entitled to a portion of the Mother Crystal's bounty. And, being such good friends, we elected to increase that portion. And share the benefits. And now that these crystals are officially property of the Kingdom of Walud, we are duty-bound not to interfere, no matter where they might happen to end up next.
Did you get all that? They're in cahoots!
So it would seem.
My lord, what is the meaning of this?
Double-crossing dogs. They're not here to do business. Kill them. Kill them both.
Over yet, Uncle!
Good! I'm just getting warmed up!
Ugh!
That wasn't too bad. How'd you like my performance, huh? I've often played the villain on the stage. I think I did the role justice. Don't you?
Greybeard, you were magnificent. The battle scene was particularly thrilling. Such a shame you didn't have more of an audience, but perhaps that's for the best.
How long have you been watching?
Long enough to witness your uncle's sordid transaction. I hardly expected one so venerable to degrade himself so thoroughly. Buying one's way into the confidence of degenerates. Ingenious.
This was the trouble you spoke of. The men of the Rock taking Crystal's men for the common folk and conspiring with the Royalists. Well, now it's over.
Indeed it is. The people of Dalamil had scarcely any means of redress against Kupka's men, let alone a foreign army. Until you two came along, that is. Well, we'd better get these crystals back to town. You won't mind waiting with them while I fetch a wagon. It occurs to me that I still don't know your name.
Clive.
So, Sid the Second is a Clive. I suppose it could have been worse. Well, Clive, you held up your end of the bargain, so I must do the same. Passage through the South Gate, was it not? To tell the truth, you've helped a little there too. Many of the guards have already been redeployed to deal with the issue of their missing comrades. And those left behind have been encouraged to look the other way should you attempt to pass through.
Thank you. And please allow me to cover your costs. You still have the purse I gave to the soldiers, I trust? I saw you pluck it from one of the bodies.
Oh, dear. Was I really so obvious?
And my name is not Greybeard. It is Lord Byron Rosfield, thank you very much.
No, thank you very much. Greybeard.
Of all the...
Here, wear this. Any friend of mine who sees you with it shall be a friend of yours.
Thank you, Lubor.
And please, feel free to send one of my Stolices back to your people. Tell them that Rosina Dalamil is back in bed with Sid.
Whom you lost, Elan, to his Achilles.
I'm trusting you, Sid. Or should I say, Clive? So be sure not to let me down. I have a reputation to uphold. Well then, I wish you a safe journey south.
Thank you.
Not at all. It was my pleasure.
Come on, Uncle. Let's go.
Clive. You and I... What? Alas,
still. Ours is a blessed corner of the Velcroy. At least they did. So, how very fitting. Of course. There's simply no other way. Don't be a stranger.
I've never even forged a butter knife before.
Perhaps Forge Master Luba's having fun at my expense.
I wouldn't put it past him.
Neither would I.
Oh, wait. Are you Clive? Sorry, my mind was elsewhere. I'm Sava, Master Luba's least accomplished apprentice. Soon to be former apprentice if I don't pass this test. Maybe I'm just not the resourceful type. People are buying up weapons faster than the Briar's Kiss can forge them, and here I am, unable to make a decent bit of kitchenware. He wants me to make a carving knife, one that embodies the spirit of Dalamil. Whatever that's supposed to mean. I don't suppose you have any idea what he's on about, do you?
I'm afraid not.
Never mind. Thought I'd ask. It was that or pack my bags.
I could give you a hand if you like. I know how busy the Briar's Kiss has been, and that Lubor needs all the capable hands he can find.
I'd be a fool to refuse.
So, where do we start?
Good question. If I'm honest, I've never made any kind of knife before. And then there's this little riddle to keep in mind, the spirit of Dalamil. Nothing is ever simple with that man.
The way I see it, there's only one way we'll be solving Lupor's puzzle. We need information. The more the better.
You're right. There's no point fumbling in the dark, I suppose. Now, who to speak to first? Well, there's plenty of folk in Dalamil who use knives for a living. There's the butcher, of course, and any number of cooks. They're bound to have an opinion or two about the tools of their trade. All right. I think we have a plan. Let's get to it, shall we? I'll talk to every cook I can find. You speak to the butcher and anyone else you can think of.
All right. Good luck.
Let's hope that someone says something useful.
Trust Lubor to take a simple test and turn it into a riddle. I'd better get to it.
The finest fabric!
It
take
was
a sniff, good sir. You'll be transported.
Welcome, sir. What can I do you for?
A question, if you don't mind. I need to know what makes a good carving knife.
You a blacksmith or something?
Something, I suppose.
Fair enough. Knives, is it? First and foremost, it's got to hold an edge. Most knives will make it through fat no problem, but sinew dulls cheap steel in no time. Give me a blade which can slice through anything that crosses my chopping block, and I'm a happy woman.
So a knife that stays sharp. Makes sense.
Put a knife with an edge like Odin's razor in my hand, and I'll make short work of any carcass.
The baths are, closed for scrubbing. Please bear with us a little longer.
Everything I've worked for, ruined. All those years of toil, every coin I've ever earned is tied up in this place.
Are you all right?
The baths are closed. Leave me be. On second thought, perhaps you are just what I need. Might your services be for hire?
That depends on the job.
I'd have you save my business, the baths. The water's turned scalding hot and all the crystals in Dalimil wouldn't be enough to cool it. I've no doubt that my woes stem from the water's source. But I can't go and investigate for fear of my customers thinking I've abandoned the place. I'm bound to these baths in more ways than one. I beg of you, go to Dusnov Terraces. Tell me what you find there.
All right. I'll go and take a look.
Wonderful. It's not far. Leave the market by the south gate. The smell of sulfur will guide you the rest of the way. These baths are all that keep me from an ignoble end in a debtor's prison. My livelihood, my very life, is at stake.
Open the gate!
Lubor was true to his word.
What is it? Me no move for chatter.
Sorry. Do you mind if I ask your trade?
Hunter? Why?
I have a question. Can you tell me what makes a good carving knife? I assume you use one out in the field.
Oh. Has to be able to put up with some punishment. Can't be dealing with a brittle blade, not while I'm on the hunt. If your knife snaps every time you use it, you'll be spending coin as fast as you make it. Times are hard enough as it is.
Thank you. I won't keep you any longer.
All business, eh? Man after my own heart.
So, a carving knife should be hard-wearing and hold an edge. Hardly a revelation. Let's hope Sava had better luck than I did.
See, I'm busy. Unless you'd like a closer look at my knives.
We'll be all right.
What do you want? Directions? Either take this road to the Fang, or piss off back the way you came.
Ah, I'm not too late.
What is it, Lubor?
A question that I neglected to ask earlier. Where is it that you're bound?
To Drake's Fang. To finish Hugo Kupka.
Just as I thought. Then allow me to share a secret. Drake's Fang is currently riddled with royalists. Talmeki and Walud are allies, and as you have seen, their soldiers work hand in glove. But no nation has ever before allowed a foreign army to make a barracks of its holiest of holies.
Not by choice, at least.
And there's more. My man on the inside of the Fang has failed to report for several days. I fear there may be more trouble lying in wait for you on the road ahead.
Isn't there always?
If you're determined to beard the lion's den, then promise me one thing. That you will enter via the mines, where the guard is lightest. I've lost one Sid already. If I lose another, people will start to think me careless.
I don't plan on dying. Not before Kupka does, anyway.
Well, so long as you have a plan.
Drake's Fang should be just beyond these springs. Shall we press on?
Come on, girl. The gate's open now. We can press on. Don't tell me you put down roots.
Come on.
You deserve a rest.
I do. Trader, are you? Seeking your fortune down in the golden sands of Dalamil? From mercantile stock myself, as happens. You'd never guess. I was born just down the road in Dravosht. And like my old ma and pa, I've been wandering the world hunting Gilbard's blessing ever since. Reckon I might have found it, too. You've heard about the famous healing waters they got round these parts, right? Well, I'm thinking, if I can find a little pool of my own, dress it up a bit, lay on drinks and fancies and whatnot, I'd have a license to mint gill. Soothing your aches and pains with a grape in your gob and a glass in your hand. There's nothing people wouldn't pay.
What the hell are those things?
Ready, girl?
Fly, Ambrosia.
Something awful's taken up residence in the springs. You'll turn back if you know what's good for you.
The heat.
Thank you.
Let's cool things down a bit. Let's hope it's enough to keep the baths from boiling.
Have been up to their old tricks again.
Drake's Fang is one of the most heavily guarded places. This is in the Republic. You'll need your wits about you.
For another of my lectures. How may I help you today? Of course. One must understand one's place in the world. Thus ends today's lesson.
Who's this blue blood? Sid's associates.
Family, more likely. I heard tell he's highborn.
And what can I do for you?
If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. Or don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Back, are you? So, will it be? No scratches, right?
Sid's going to find Cooker and finish the job.
That's right. We're safe here.
Not crossing the Velcro. It's dead easy to get lost in the desert. I should know.
Jill's staying here, and that's that. I should have never let her go with you to Rosalith.
I'm fine, Clive, really. I just need some rest.
Clive! Anything catch your eye? Think you can help?
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Come to claim your just desserts. I don't have that one. You do. All done?
This is no good. I was hoping to get out of the heat for a little while.
Is it true what I'm hearing?
So, how'd it go? You learn anything useful, or should I be looking for a new trade?
Only that a blade should be durable and stay sharp. But I don't see how that relates to the spirit of Dalamil.
I didn't have much luck either. All the cook said was that he needs his knives to be light. Too heavy, and they do his shoulder in.
So we're no better off than when we started. Perhaps Lubor didn't mean anything with his Dalamil remark. But that can't be right. I've bandied enough words with the man to know that he chooses them carefully. No. We must be missing something. Something right in front of our noses, most likely.
No doubt you're right, but I have to make a start soon. I can't put off making this knife forever.
Agreed. Lubor wouldn't like that much.
Right. I've been trained to work iron. The cheap stuff, mind. But it's hardy enough if you don't hammer it too thin, and it sharpens up nicely with a bit of effort. Trouble is, it's either durable or it's light, meaning someone is going to be disappointed. Forge Master Lubor, probably.
Is there no one else you can turn to? Someone who knows their metals, perhaps?
The other apprentice is no better than to help me with my test. But maybe there is someone I could turn to. A merchant, a favorite of Forge Master Lubor's, who sells metals to tradesmen passing through the Velcroy. I bet she'd know a thing or two.
Good girl.
Yeah!
Lord Cook has finally made his move.
Yes. He deserves a rest. Any soldiers in town to deal with any Imperial reprisals.
Any luck? Or will you be needing help with your bags?
Well, I asked her, but... you tell him.
If you're looking to make a knife that will impress a master like Lubor, there are options. They're just not that viable. Featherlight adamantite knives will get passed from generation to generation, never needing so much as a lick of the whetstone. But adamantite ore is unique to Ash, so it doesn't come cheap.
And it's beyond my skill to handle.
Unique to Ash. Are there any materials unique to Dalamil? Something which could be mixed with iron to refine it. Make it lighter.
What are you getting at?
You said that Lubor trained you to work iron. Then that's what he'll expect you to use. But he would have known that it would either be too heavy or too brittle for a carving knife. Perhaps his Dalamil remark wasn't a riddle, but a hint.
If it's cheap metal you're using, then there's always limestone, I suppose. Folk first settled Dalamil to get at her mineral deposits. And, if you know the trick, it can be melted down in the furnace to drive out impurities from low-quality iron.
Bloody hell! That must be it! I don't suppose you know the trick, do you?
It's hardly my speciality, but I've been around enough blacksmiths to know how it works.
Looks like I've got some learning to do. Clive, I hate to ask after all that you've done for me, but...
The limestone? Fine. I can hardly abandon you now. Besides, I want to know if this is the answer to Lubor's little riddle.
I can't thank you enough, Clive. You'll have no trouble finding limestone over in the terraces. The place is bloody made of it!
Then I suppose I'll meet you back at the forge.
Right you are. I'll see you shortly. So, do you crush it up, or just throw it in the furnace?
Who do you think those soldiers were in the inn?
Friends of friends, I'd wager. Not that they looked very friendly.
This is no good.
Is it true what I'm hearing?
My carpet!
Take a sniff, good sir.
Kneaded to a silken softness.
Made from the stoutest...
There he is. The man who saved my business. I was hoping we'd be seeing you again. The bath's grown more bearable by the moment.
It won't be long now before we are back to business as usual.
I'm glad to hear it.
Now, tell me this. What did you find at the terraces? What threatened to make me a pauper?
Not what I expected, that's for certain.
You tell a fine story. That's not to say I don't believe you, though. Creatures made of flame, eh? That's something new to worry about. But I burdened you with my worries enough already. Here, a small something by way of thanks. Right, it's high time I got back to work. With a little luck, the day might yet be salvaged. It's just as well I sent you to the terraces in my stead. It sounds like I'd have been burnt to a crisp.
The, scrubbing is almost finished. We appreciate your patience.
Hanging lanterns, keep the darkness
from your... Well, we can make our way back to the Fang now, at least.
Yeah, but what would be the point? With the mine still closed.
You're a friend of Lubor's, aren't you? Everyone's getting their crystals now, if that's what you're worried about. So, let's leave it there, shall we? No sense making a mountain out of a molehill. Not now the vermin are gone.
Finally, we'll be able to get what's owed us.
We should get going soon. Do you have water?
I've got a crystal. So long as we stay out of the Deadlands, we'll be all right.
Good girl.
Yeah!
Thanks, girl.
One rock looks a lot like another. But hopefully this is what Sava needs.
Light meat and dark.
It would make us
the finest fabrics.
I hear you and the master are working together now. Glad to have you on board.
I wasn't sure how much you'd need, but I hope this is enough.
You are one of the good ones, you know that.
You and that merchant both, she's got quite a gift for teaching that one.
Now, time to see if limestone is the secret weapon we were hoping for. That'll do, I reckon. A knife forged from the very rocks of Dalamil. Her spirit, if you will.
It's a fine-looking blade.
I only hope Master Lubor agrees.
That sounds like my cue. And just as well. I was getting tired of waiting.
I'm sorry, Forge Master Lubor.
Let's take a look then, shall we? First things first, Sava, do you think this is a carving knife worthy of the fine people of Dalamil?
I'd like to think so. But what do you think?
What do I think indeed? It's sharp-ish, but it won't last long with hard use. And it's heavy, heavier than it should be. You might not think it just to hold it for a moment, but sell that to a cook and you'll never hear the end of it. It looks like someone paid a visit to the terraces. The limestone was a step in the right direction, granted, but one that still leaves you short of the mark.
And I was so certain I had it all worked out.
I don't know who you found to teach you that little trick, but it certainly shows initiative. Next question. How much do you think I would charge if I'd made this?
Well, if it took you even a fraction of the time it took me, I
say you could demand a heavy purse.
And who would be able to pay that? The butcher? The hunter? The cooks over at the inn? Dalimilla's home to humble traders, not wealthy lords and ladies. Rule number one in any business, Sava, know your customers.
Yes, Forgemaster.
This is just about passable. But only just. I'd say you're worth keeping around a little longer. Starting tomorrow, you'll have an anvil of your own.
I will. Thank you. I was wondering, what would you do if you were asked to forge a carving knife?
I'd do what I always do. Ask who it's for. If it was for the butcher, I'd make sure it holds an edge. For the hunter, I'd make it as tough as Titan. For the cook, light as a feather. And for the nobleman, I'd make it cost an absolute fortune.
There goes a master, all right.
It looks like congratulations are in order.
I couldn't have done it without you. So much for the Forge Master's riddle, though, eh? The spirit of Dalimil had nothing to do with limestone or anything much at all. Meaning, I had you run around for no good reason.
You've passed your test. That's all that matters. You'll have a forge of your own in no time.
And when I do, I'll craft you the finest carving knife you have ever seen.
I don't think I could have done it without all your help.
Clive. Best of luck.
The most fragrant herbs and
juiciest
fresh bread,
warm from the oven.
Plates and pots!
Silver platters! Hanging lanterns! Pink.
Finally, we'll be able to get what's over.
We should get going soon.
Come on.
Faster!
Come on, girl.
Broken down, you say? From the weight of its load?
Aye. The guards are furious about it. You'd do well to steer clear.
Well, if it's blocking the road, it'd be a wasted journey anyway.
Get that damned wagon fixed! Unless you'd rather our men in Dalimil starved.
The axle's gone, Captain. There's nothing I can do.
Ready, go?
Fly, Ambrosia!
There it is. Drake's Fang.
Good.
Kupka will be hiding inside.
Along with goodness knows how many guards, all on highest alert, you'll need to keep your wits about you if you're to reach him. So be careful.
I will, Uncle.
Before you go, Clive, allow me to apologize. After what befell at Phoenix Gate and the crisis that followed in its wake, I fled. I retreated to my counting house and danced attendance upon the Vicereine in the hope it would bring me favor. I betrayed my nation to save my skin, like the coward I am. And I'm sorry.
Uncle, please.
It's not too late, Clive. Rosaria is yours by right, and there are those that would help you to take it back. Had I the courage of my brother, I might already have done so. But that ship has sailed. You, however.
No. Forgive me, but I cannot. I fight to build a new world now. A better world. Where men can live and die on their own terms. I was raised in a nation that strove to improve the plight of bearers. Only later did I realize that spark of freedom did not arise by chance, but was kindled by my father. You would see me follow in his footsteps. And that is exactly what I mean to do. Not by ruling Rosaria, but by extending his ideals to the whole of the Twins. Though every soul in the realm may judge my actions heresy, I am certain my cause is just.
You really are just like him, you know? Thank you, Clive, for coming back to me. I am proud to call you nephew. Well then, this is where we must part ways. Wish me luck in convincing my Canvarian friend to share his considerable talents. I mean to plunder his coffers and prove myself worthy of a place in your merry band. Till then, my boy.
Till then. Go safely, Uncle.
And you, nephew. We have much to catch up on, you and I. I shall expect you to regale me with the tales of all your adventures when next we meet. You can regale me too, Torgal.
I'm coming for you, Kupka.
Stuart! What has that guzzle rat done to me? Out of my sight, witch! I'll kill you, Rosfield! I'll rip out your heart! I'll tear you limb from limb!
Peace, Hugo. The table shan't hurt you any longer.
He sought to humiliate me. Me! If you hadn't interfered, he would be dead!
You truly believe you would have triumphed had the battle continued?
Titan would have ground him into dust!
And how would he have done that without his head?
Shut up!
You weren't strong enough, and you call yourself a dominant. Or rather, you did.
You mock me, Harbert.
Do you see, Hugo? You are weak.
Fuck!
But so long as that fire burns within you, there is still hope. There may yet be a way for you to take your revenge.
Tell me, what must I do? Please, I'll do anything. Just tell me.
The heart.
What of it?
A mother crystal's heart is the most concentrated source of ether in all creation. Perhaps you could take advantage of that. Of course, the crystal would not yield her blessing to any ordinary man. But then, you are no ordinary man. Clive Rosfield stole your power, but others have suffered a similar fate, and still managed to find the strength to conjure their icon. Like Benedicta Harmon. She too drank of the ether and gained a power beyond human understanding.
She did.
Run along now, Hugo. You need only follow the light. Muthos is here. Very well, it shall be so. You may leave everything to me, Your Majesty.
the Royalists bring them from Ash? The Beastmen part of the Waluda army now. How the hell did that happen? must be the way out.
Attack!
Too slow. Come on, Torgal.
Kupka never did do things by halves. As if taking the Mother Crystal for his own wasn't enough. He had to build his castle in it.
Let the trial begin.
Too slow.
Seems we're expected.
So this is the power of Muthos.
Did the orcs do this too? What the hell is going on? Are these things here for me? Or for him? First orcs, now these nightmares. Is this your doing, Ultima? Ah! Nice try. You've been busy, Kupka. But where did you go? He's in the sanctuary. I can feel it. Come on, Toggle.
Thank you.
Benedicta. My everything. I've missed you so much.
Kuka!
I swear to you, my love. We will never be parted again.
What's wrong with him? No.
it.
You can do it.
And so could I! Let's give this a try. Not bad.
Kuka!
Thank you. too low.
Thank you.
hate you, Ultima.
What do you want?
Your soul is tainted with worthless human will, yet your thirst for power remains undiminished. With every sip you take, you grow in strength, and soon you shall achieve perfection.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You will accept us, Muthos. It is inevitable. You were created for this purpose, and you shall serve it.
Never!
You of your will to claim our vessel. It appears we first have to sever every thread of the consciousness that supports it. No matter. The time to build a new world is not yet upon us. We will contemplate.
One can no more command the power of ether by drowning in its flood than one can constrain the tides by standing in the sea. I had thought Hugo wiser than this, but it seems his head was full of rocks after all.
Titan was strong.
Your Majesty.
But Muthos is stronger. For 5 years, that man lived only for revenge, clinging fast to a fiction, even as it swept him into the abyss. One cannot change one's nature through force of will alone. Only the Almighty can do that.
Hugo Kupka, the man who gave his life for a woman's head. A fool like all the rest.
Of a mother crystal should be so beautiful.
Some medicine, my lord? I have salves, potions, anything you need.
Stop bothering me, urchin, or you'll feel the back of my hand.
You must consider your health, my prince. If a show of force is needed to keep the Dalmex at bay, you may trust in your dragoons. I beg you to call on Bahamut only as a last resort. His strength comes at too great a cost.
The Empire agreed to an armistice with the Republic, and yet the Emperor still plots its ruin. For now, the Dalmechs suspect nothing. And as long as I can hold their gaze, war need not be inevitable. But more than that, Bahamut is the champion of the Empire. When our people look to the heavens, the sight of him gives them hope. Forgive me, Terence. Would that you were my master. But alas.
I will always be your loyal servant.
Should the Council's brazen maneuvering prompt the Republic to tear up their own treaty and launch a new assault, our soldiers would advance to meet them, cutting across the central aisles, but not in time to prevent their forces from breaching the southern defenses and storming Twinside. And so the capital would become a battlefield. Thousands of innocents would die. I cannot allow that to happen.
There is one small mercy, at least. You will not be forced to do battle with Titan.
Would that I could avoid doing battle at all.
1,000 pardons, Your Highness.
What is it?
Olivier has been made Emperor. What is the meaning of this?
My father's orders. What were they? Quickly! Yes, Your Highness. His Radiance requests that Your Highness maintain position here and...
Yes, my prince.
I must go to the palace.
I'll ready your steed.
What is it now?
Forgive the intrusion, Your Highness.
I know you.
At ease.
We stand in the presence of the Phoenix. You wouldn't want to get your fingers burned.
I hope I'm not interrupting.
Not at all. Though I admit, I did not expect such a distinguished guest.
How many years has it been since the remembrance ceremony? 20?
I thought you long dead. Do I address a ghost?
Many have told me that I look like one. But no. I'm alive. Just. Prince Dion of the House Lesage, I have a tale to tell you.
I'd better give Otto the good news.
This had better be the lot. It's a skiff, or a bloody cargo freighter. Walkways need patching up. Give me 50 good boards, 8 span each.
Welcome home, Sid.
Anything.
Try to stay calm. I'm sure we'll hear something soon.
Gav told me the gentleman who visited earlier, the one with the loud voice, was your uncle. I did think there was a resemblance. Something in the eyes.
Seen troops amassing at every border crossing.
Well, no surprises there. It was the same after Drake's breath.
Here for another of my lectures.
What is it that you wish to learn?
Of course. Study it well, Clive. Very good.
Clive, you're back.
I am. And with glad tidings for once. Hugo Kupka is no more.
Well, I'll be. All of our comrades who lost their lives back at Sid's place. Smiling down at you right now.
We had a stallus from Lubor saying Drake's fang had fallen. I expect that was your doing as well, was it?
It's a long story.
One for the history books, I'll bet.
Welcome home, Clive.
It's good to be back. You look better.
I feel it. Which means I'm coming on your next little adventure. You're not leaving me behind again.
Wouldn't dream of it. Otto. Any word on the Royalist movement since I've been away?
Shouldn't you be putting your feet up? If you really want to know, go and have a word with Vivian.
Thank you. I will.